どうもこんにちは、宮崎です。私はですね、今チェコのピルスナウルケルというねビールの工場に来ております。今日はですね、これからこの工場のね工場見学をする予定です。ピルスナウルケルっていうと、すごく有名なねビールの工場なので、結構ねもう知ってる人も多いんじゃないかなと思います。そこでですね、今回これを紹介します。
And it comes from 100 meter deep wells.
Wow.
Yeah. And so that's underground water, and it's soft water, which is actually really important for the final taste of beer. And here we use our own special culture of yeast, which actually in the year 1842 brought to our brewery the first brewmaster, Joseph Grohl. And since then we keep them, we still use them.And we use them only here and nowhere else in the world. And these are so-called pellets. They are made from a dry cones of hops. So here you have this cone. They dry them and then they press it into these small forms, so-called pellets. We use them like this because they can keep the intensity of taste longer than if we use the dry hops. So here you can see the ingredients we need to make a beer. So first of all, we have the Pilsen soft water.
Mm-hmm.
We have like Czech and Moravian barley we make malt from. We have the Saaz hops,
mm-hmm.
or yeah, you know, it's in English it's Saaz, in Czech it's like Žatecko, Žatec. And our own culture of yeast. And actually all these four ingredients comes only from Czech Republic.
Wow.
And because we are making the beer still the traditional way, during the highest quality.
はい、今歴代の醸造マスターの、コーナーに来てます。この人は何歳に見えますかって聞かれたので、40歳ぐらいでしょうかって言ったら25歳以下ですって言われました。初代の方ですね。でそこから、歴代の方々がこんな風にずらっと並んでいます。たくさんの方が醸造マスターとして働いていて、今の人はこの辺なのかな。この方が今のマスターだそうです。
And they were dug out only by hands, and they are made in the sandstone. You can see here we have two parts of cellars. One is over here. These are lager cellars. Here was the beer maturing in lager barrels. And the other part is over here. And do you remember what was the name of the restaurant?
No.
It was called Na Spilce. In Czech it means something like on the top or above spilka. So spilka is this part. It's actually the fermentation room. Yeah?
Okay.
And in this fermentation room, the spilka was the fermentation of beer was happening.
So is it real beer?
It's real.
Wow.
It's totally real. you can see here that on each pet we are using awesome brandings. The LE stands for lager in Czech.
Mm-hmm.
2nd of September is date of beginning, the fermentation. 5 degrees Celsius is temperature at the beginning. H stands for type of yeast. And the three means we use these three times already. We can use them four times in the total.
Mm-hmm.
Every day, during the fermentation, we are measuring the temperature and the temperature is increasing. It's
wow.
because of the process of fermentation, and you can see on the top there's foam. Foam starts to develop from the second day of fermentation, and at the end it's like big, heavy, and it should be a little bit brown. So after 12 days of fermentation, here in the cellars, we draw the beer inside of the lager barrels. And here in the lager barrels, grandfather's birthday. Mm. After his birthday, the beer is done. It's ready to drink. So now we can go taste one of these beers.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh. Yeah.
Just giving
the glass and
he tap you
the beer. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
今この樽から出してもらったビールを飲んだんですが、すごく美味しいです。伝統的な作り方でなんか試してるやつだそうです。
The color of the beer you are drinking right now is not clear. It's a little bit kind of foggy. And actually the reason is that this is the unfiltered and unpasteurized beer, so it still contains some yeast insideAnd because it was made here in the cellars by the old traditional way, this is the only place where you can drink it. Because actually this beer we make here in the cellars never leaves the cellars.
So you don't sell,
no,
for example,
this beer,
in the cans or a
restaurant?
No.
No, it's just only for the tourists and employees. And the name, Pilsner Urquell,It means like origin. It is like the original Pilsner. Because actually the Pilsner means like Pilsens, like that is what comes from Pilsen. And the Urquell means like origin and source. And it's named like this because in the past, like I said, this was like the first Pilsner lager they made. And in that time they used to call it like Pilsner beer.Yeah, but because actually everybody who made beer in Pilsen can call it Pilsner beer.
Yes.
There was like the confusing about what was the first one, what is the true original.
Mm-hmm.
So they name it like Pilsner Urquell. It's actually in German. Okay.
Like this?
Yeah, a little bit more low.
Yes.
Yeah, easy, right?
Okay, so the person enters the barrel and wash.
Yes, they wash it and they came back.
はい、見学ツアーが終わってお土産物屋さんに来ました。まあツアーの最後に寄るような場所ですね。いろんなものが売ってます。まあ当たり前ですけどね、普通にこのピルスナービールの瓶、缶、それからグループ会社のビール。グループ会社のビールもいろいろと売ってて、あとまあ T シャツとかパーカーとかジョッキグラスとか、ジョッキグラスが面白そう。はい、そうですね、こんな感じのジョッキグラスが売ってますね。 T シャツとかもいろいろ売ってます。はい、今ねピルスナーウルケルの、ビール工場のね見学ツアーが終わりました。めちゃくちゃ面白かったですね。なんか最初はちょっともうね、ビールの作り方みたいなところは私結構もう知ってたので、何箇所もねもうビール工場の見学行ったことがあったのでちょっとつまんないかなと思ったんですけど、最後の方にね、もうここでしか飲むことができないビールを飲めたりとか、まあね昔ながらの作り方でやってるのを見れたりとか、そこはねもうめちゃくちゃ面白かったですね。ピルスナウルケルがね好きっていう方は本当ここでしか飲めないビールっていうのがあるので、ぜひねここ見学に来てほしいなと思いました。もう普通のね缶で売ってるものとかとは全然作り方も違いますし、もう本当の本当のあのピルスナウルケルと言っていいんじゃないかなというのはふうに思います。ぜひビール工場の見学来てもらいたいなと思います。はい、今回の動画ねこれで終わりです。今回のね、このツアーは、チェコ親善アンバサダー2019の個別プレスツアーということでですね、飛行機代ですとかホテル代、それからね、現地での交通費の一部をねチェコ、政府観光局の方に負担していただいております。非常にですね、 充実した旅を過ごしていて、他にもねたくさん、ブログとか YouTube でねチェコの魅力を発信してます。なのでぜひ他のね動画とかそれからブログの方もね、見てみてください。それからもちろんね Twitter、Instagram とかでもね、チェコの情報を発信してますので、そっちもね合わせてチェックしてもらえると嬉しいです。はい、今回の動画ね面白かったらぜひいいね、それからチャンネル登録の方よろしくお願いします。まだまだねチェコの旅は続くので、他のねいろいろね発信していきたいと思います。ぜひ見てみてください。ではまた。